Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Very good morning to everyone. Today we will look at our question 2, or because this is the first tutorial for this subchapter of photovoltaic. So we are going to calculate how many power on the array based on the layout given, and also how many power we can develop from average sun exposure at that position. Okay, so if this is the question that I given to student on 2018-2019 on the test. So, let's go through this first. We have question 2, A, B, and C there. A, B, and C. If we read carefully, question A and B is on photovoltaic, and question 2C is biodiesel subchapter. It's our subtopic. Okay, so we will only cover for this session on question A and B. Okay, question 2, let me read it to you. List and describe a few basic equipment to produce alternate current harnessing from the sun radiation. Okay, list and describe. If you look carefully at this question, it asks you find or to list up and describe. You must list the equipment and describe all those equipment, apa yang equipment tu, dia punya functionality of that equipment lah. Okay, at least you need four equipment to get 4 marks. Kalau you tulis list saja 4 and not describe, you dapat 2. Okay, half kalau you, for example lah, solar panel, battery, apa lagi, wire, of course, alternating converter tu, converter, and what else? You need solar charger. Yes, solar charger. So half. Kalau you tak describe dia, you tak dapat full marks. Yes, ni sebab the question ask you to list and describe. List saja you dapat, untuk satu komponen you dapat half mark. Okay. Untuk question number 2, figure question 2B shows the arrangement of photovoltaic on the rooftop. Expose the array 2 and 3 to the sun for an average of 3.8 hours daily. You kena pastikan mana satu array. You baca kat sini, ada array 1, array 2, then this is array 1, array 2, and this is array 3. Okay, so array 2 and array 3, expose setiap hari 3.8 hour daily. Okay, while the array 1, they expose lebih kurang 2.9 hours daily. Okay, now you baca detail lagi dekat array 1 and array 2. And array 3 ada apa solar panel kat situ. Kalau you baca, let me zoom clearly here. Dekat array 1 dia ada 15 LG solar. LG ni jenama lah, brand solar tu lah. So ada 15 unit of solar with watt peak 305 watt, and 2 sun print 300 watt. dia punya tilted dia pada 21 degree dan diletakkan pada azimut 180 degree. So boleh nampak lah kat sini. So dia ada 15 LG solar panel, kemudian dia ada satu sun frame, ada dua sun frame kat sini. Okay, dia letak dalam satu array, dipanggil dia array 1. Kalau array 2 hanya satu jenis saja. Okay, dia letak kat sini 10 unit LG solar 350 watt. Kemudian array 3 ada 2 sahaja di sini, 300 watt. Okay, so soalan dia, dia tanya kat situ, calculate the amount of kilowatt hour collected in a day and the monthly income for the owner if the tariff for net energy metering per kilowatt hour is 0.31 sen. 30 sen lah, 31 sen lah ni maksud dia. So berapa jumlah watt day and the monthly income for the owner boleh dapat kalau dia susun dia punya solar panel dia dekat atas bumbung rumah dia macam ni, berapa. Kemudian question 2, B2, propose to the owner on how to increase the monthly income based on their existing PV system. Based on existing PV system, maksudnya you tak boleh rearrange dia balik lah. Okay, maksudnya you tak boleh tak boleh rearrange dia balik ataupun you tak boleh tambah. Maksud dia kat sini, yang saya nak masukkan kat sini ialah you tak boleh tambah sistem ataupun solar PV yang daripada lain lah kan. Sebab soalan soalan dia kat sini, propose to the owner how to increase. Kalau you fikir nak increase ni, you tambah je lah solar panel, lagi banyak lagi bagus kan, lagi banyak lah you dapat income monthly. Tapi maksud dia kat sini ialah macam mana nak tambah increase monthly income based on apa yang you dah ada dekat solar panel. Contoh kat sini you ada berapa je, 15, 10, 25, lebih kurang you ada 29, 5 campur 4, 9, 29 solar panel yang you ada ni. Macam mana you nak dapatkan maximum out of it, maximum income. Okay, so you kena start calculate macam ni. Okay, macam ni, you kena start calculate macam ni. Yang ini tadi you kena list up. For example, solar panel, apa solar panel buat, describe lah solar panel ni apa. Change energy from solar to current to battery. What does battery do? Storage energy. Energy storage lah. Energy storage. Kemudian, 3. Inverter. Changing DC current to AC current. 4. Apa lagi you perlukan? Solar panel, battery charger, battery controller ataupun solar charger. Solar charger to charge battery. Okay, so you dapatlah 4 marks out of it. 4 marks. Ini tak ter limited on this kind of equipment sajalah kan. Sebenarnya ada banyak lagi equipment yang diperlukan untuk convert sun radiation to alternating current kan, banyak lagi you perlukan. You perlukan miniature circuit breaker, of course you perlukan wire, you perlukan plug and others. So this is basic thing lah, basic equipment. Seterusnya yang ini tadi, macam mana kita nak jawab? Calculate the amount of energy in kilowatt hour collected in a day and the monthly income dalam unit RM for the owner if the tarif for net energy metering per kilowatt hour is 0.31 sen. Okay, kita buat macam ni, memudahkan hidup kita. Array 1, array 2, then this is array 3. Okay, array 1 ada berapa? 15 campur 2, 15 darab 305, dan 2 darab 300. So you dapat berapa? Exactly you dapat 5175 kilowatt untuk array 2. This is array 2. Array 2 ada 10 darab 305. Array 2 10 darab 305. So you dapat lebih kurang 3050 kilowatt. Untuk array 2 you ada 2 darab 300. So you dapat 600 watt. Okay, 600 watt. So what will you do after that? Dibagi tahu, array 1 expose daily 2.9 hours. So dekat array 1 tu, you continue saja sini, you darabkan nilai ni dengan 2.9 hours. Dan ni you darabkan array 2 dan array 3, berapa exposure dia? 3.8 hour. This is 3.8 hours. This is 3.8 hours. So lima satu tujuh lima, you darab dekat array 1, 5175 you darabkan dengan 2.9, so you dapat 15.0075 kilowatt hour untuk array 1. So untuk array 2 dan array 3, 3650 kilowatt hour darabkan dengan 3.8 kilowatt hour ni hours. So you dapat 3650 darab 3.8, 13,000. You dapat 13,870 kilowatt hour. 13.87 lah kilowatt hour. So from that you totalkan, totalkan 15 this and this one. So 15.75 plus 13.87 equals to 28.875 kilowatt hour. So soalan kilowatt hour you dah dapat. Collected the amount of energy kilowatt hour collected in a day and the monthly income. So you kena darabkan yang ini, nilai ini 28.8775 kilowatt hour darab 0.31 RM per 1 kilowatt hour. So ni potong you dapat. Okey. Untuk a day darab 0.31. So satu hari you dapat lebih kurang RM 8.9 ringgit, 8.95 ringgit. Okey, untuk sebulan monthly you kena darab dengan 30 lah. 30 darab this number RM 8.952025 equal to lebih kurang you dapat RM 268 ringgit 56 sen. Ini yang you dapat monthly. Okay, kalau you go through again this question. So untuk soalan question 2B1 macam ni kan, you buat bila ada total kilowatt hour sini 3 markah, 3 marks, and this you dapat 268.56 dalam unit RM, you dapat 3 marks. So sangat mudah lah, dia tak ada formula kan sini kan, dia cuma darab tambah saja. Kemudian propose to the owner on how to increase the monthly income based on their existing PV system. Okay, macam mana? Of course lah, kalau you tengok kat soalan ni, maksimum satu hari dia boleh dapat lebih kurang 3.8 hours exposure dia, 3.8 hours daily. Yang ini dia dapat minimum lah ni, bukan minimum lah, mungkin dia tak dapat semaksimum yang mungkin exposure to solar radiation. So dia dapat 2.9 hours saja daily, yang ini dapat 3.8 daily. So you need to propose, mungkin you kena letak array 1 ni, mungkin you kena letak dekat sebelah sini ke ataupun sebelah sini ke, supaya dia punya exposure dia sama dapat lebih kurang 3.8 hours daily. So when you propose to the owner, you tak boleh lah propose you kena tukar, you kena macam you cakap dengan owner, you tukarlah position array 1 ni, tukar ke arah sini, so dia dapat maximum energy. Macam tu awak nak cakap kat owner. So owner memang takkan tukarlah, unless kalau you buat satu proposal, yang proposal tu based on kira-kira lah kan, you pandai kira-kira kan. So at least you kena buat macam gini, you tahu array 1 di sini ialah total kilowatt lah, maksimum lah watt panel tu ada berapa, 15 campur 2 17 watt panel tu boleh draw 5175 kilowatt. Cuma exposure dia saja berkurangan ke sini. Okay. So you propose dekat owner, you cakap Array 1 maximum dia boleh hasilkan lebih kurang tadi berapa, 5175 kilowatt. Kalau you darabkan dengan maximum exposure macam mana Array 2 dan Array 3 dapat, iaitu 3.8 hours. So you darabkanlah 3.8 hours. So 5175 darab 3.8, you dapat kat sini 21.717 kilowatt hour. Dan array 2 maksimum lah, array 2 dan array 3 pun sama juga, dapat 3.8 juga. So tadi kita dapat array 2 and array 3 untuk 3.8 hours exposure lebih kurang 13.87 kilowatt hour. So tambahkan 13 tambah 87 dapat 21 sorry eh, 21.717 tambah 13.87. You dapat 35.587 kilowatt hour. So daily owner tu bakal dapat, kalau dia range balik rewind dia 35.587 darab 0.31, you dapat 11 ringgit daily, 3197, dan monthly dapat berapa? Darab 30. So dapat lebih kurang RM 330 ringgit 95.91 sen. Ini adalah nilai yang owner boleh dapat kalau dia rearrange saja, rearrange semula saja, bukannya beli ataupun bukannya tambah solar panel, tapi cuma rearrange saja supaya solar panel dia tu dapat exposure of sun sama dengan exposure yang array 2 dengan array 3 dapat. Okay, dia boleh increase berapa persen? RM330 daripada RM268. So lebih kurang RM268.56 bahagi 3.95.91, lebih kurang 18% increment, 18.8% increment, hanya tukar saja. Kemudian inilah income dia. So kalau you buat income, you buat proposal macam gini, ada duit sikit, beritahulah kat sini kat atas, rearrange rewind to get max exposure. Kemudian you buat calculation macam ni, at least you dapat 6 markah lah di situ. Okay, semudah itu. So there's no fixed formula for this. There's no fixed formula for this. So you can expect on the final nanti macam ginilah. Okay, macam ginilah. You can expect on the final nanti macam inilah. That's it from me. Itu saja sepatutnya yang ini diajar pada hari Selasa dan hari Rabu. Sepatutnya ada kelas tapi tak boleh buat kelas. So saya tak buat kelas lah. Itu saja. Sorry again interrupting your days. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.